I get a ding. I got a Discord blip. Matt Rule just slightly looking to the side. Those are very different numbers. Those are very different players. Pretty similar numbers. I throw it like 20 times a game. Or Fritcher. Okay.
Carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. Fights through and now a crease. And they get it.
Runs DMT for ya. Are you having flashbacks?
19 yards.
And there's Christian McCaffrey with another run. Run CMC as he's known in the Carolina area.
Not quite Jim Brown, but he's still pretty good.
Back in the league last season. 2,392 yards from scrimmage. He's just so dangerous every time he gets the football. Whether you hand it to him, throw it to him out of the backfield, just imagine if they had the guts to let him return kicks as well. This guy is a true triple threat.
So a big penalty there on the face mask leads to first and 10. Now it's a bootleg with Bridgewater. He'll get this to McCaffrey out of the backfield. Oh, an absolute.
There's nothing you can do.
He's got some space now. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and 2.
You did, but it didn't matter because Christian McCaffrey.
Bridgewater gonna give this to McCaffrey. And they'll get this one.
He's so exhausted. Oh, Russell Okung's hurt.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league.
Pretty funny.
Had to come into this game with the idea. Slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
And the Panthers are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3 yard line. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. On the ground, McCaffrey. And he is in. Touchdown, Carolina.
I can help with that if you want.
Christian McCaffrey, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead.
The kick is good.
And this will be good to get.
Christian McCaffrey's pretty good at the football.
The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. And this will make it into the end zone. And that decision to bring it out
went right through him.
Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
Big man.
Brings up second and 4 at the 26 yard line.
Here's Geis.
Jackson.
And he'll go down right at the 30 yard line.
Very large man.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 point score gives yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
First 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving. Jackson on first down.
short throw underneath to Hurst. I didn't want to get juked, so I tried to play the juke, but you didn't juke. I can't cover you for 6 years. Roughing the passer somehow. There's nothing I can do about it. It just forces me to tackle you. It literally forces me to tackle you. There's nothing I can do. Okay, I like that nobody attempted to tackle him. Did you see that? They're just like, nah, go ahead. Free real estate. I think the answer was, you have to get me down, so you have to, like, get an interception, and I have to play from behind. That was the only way you really stopped me, to where I can't run it. Free real estate. Real estate to be.
That's a third down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play from Falcon territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 46.
Now a run like the draw play, Anthony Lynn style.
About the 43. Christian McCaffrey. A gain of 3, second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. Still open for the coordinator.
And he'll go down here at the 30.
First down anyway.
That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Oh.
And the Panther first down.
What?
From the gun, Bridgewater.
Suit yourself. I was so confused why you pressed me with no safety help. I was like, okay. Do you think I won't take it? Apparently not.
And the Panthers have taken the lead. And he's got it.
I was so confused. I think all my receivers have like 95 plus speed.
Team on the field now as they will send this one away. Takes this about 5 yards deep.
What? Ted Ginn Jr.
To the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line, and they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback
making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
Your uniforms look like Hershey bars.
They need to make in the passing game.
Pass rush, pass rush,
all this motion crap. Where are you going?
Here, and it looks like we've got a Panther that's having some difficulty down there getting up.
step aside and be right back.
Held onto it? What a... Okay, that's just the game handing it to you. I can't do anything about that. I can't. That's not fair. He got tackled by four people and held on to it. What am I supposed to do? You are getting Madden bullshit on your side. Didn't step out, but okay. What just happened? I'm sorry, what? What? What the hell was that? Alright, game, just bullshit. That's fine, too. He didn't even try to catch it. Look. Nothing I can do about that. I like that he just stood immediately up and gave the guy a hug. That's just Teddy Bridgewater's limitations. Not really my fault on that pick. Great. Can my people stop getting hurt? This is my fourth injury of the game. Four injuries, Dippy. That's ridiculous. What's the injury slider on? There's nothing I can do. I'm just getting hurt.
Charles, how much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines.
And he'll take this Curtis Samuel. The end zone, touchdown, Carolina. Curtis Samuel, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead. It's good, and it is now 21-7. Makes the score.
The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
At their own 20-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And you have to figure they won't just sit on the football here in the final minute. The way that Jackson hit
oof.
The football.
Oof.
Panthers, and they will have the football deep in.
This escalated quickly.
At the 10-yard line.
All right.
They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And the Panthers are going to be
McCaffrey.
First and goal is a nice run there. Gets him down to the 6-yard line.
The tackle made at the 6-yard line.
On second and goal, Bridgewater.
He stopped running. Did you see him? Well, it would have mattered had he kept running. I don't know what you're talking about. Wouldn't matter. He stopped running. Look, the ball kept going. If he keeps running, you don't, because then your guys aren't in position to pick it. I don't know what you're talking about. Are you forgetting how gravity works? momentum, if he keeps running, that ball is placed to where he'll run into the ball. But I had to stop and throw it behind me. Terry's giving you shit for not being good on first down, apparently. Can you stop? Which hill is that? Okay, not Tyreek Hill. That's all I care about. That was. What that sound was. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Now he dumps this off over the middle, and this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 6 yards the pick up, and Joe Flacco over here. Other than me, got hurt. Or I've lost half my fucking roster in this game. And I love just being beaten by fucking checkdowns the entire time. And then you ran the rest of the place. I know, I'm just saying, it's just frustrating because I know there's nothing I can do about it. I didn't say cheese, did I? I'm just being beaten by checkdown. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly. Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? Second and six, just inside the 30. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. Stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six.
Grady Jarrett on the tackle there. Remember how he emerged in the Super Bowl against New England? Continues to step his play up. Was a Pro Bowler for the first time after 2019.
Open man is Anderson.
Too much speed. And he will take it across for a like 94? It's up there.
They were dynamic in the first half. The halftime break, that didn't slow them down at all. Big strike here in the third quarter.
It's almost as if they were saying, it's not just our skill in the first half is getting this done, it's confidence as well. And confidence has taken over this game in a big way. How about these strikes that we're seeing?
Or I'm being bailed out by defensive talent.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the
line. And you're a whack of defensive talent. What happened? Why would he in that animation? He started doing the animation like he was being tackled, but he wasn't. Dislocated hip. Like, seriously, that would break your fucking legs. They're not a fan of you.
A 7-yard pickup brings up second and 3 at the 42 yard. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports.
Falcons 14.
Play action. It's Jackson.
I can't do anything. There's nothing I can do. I can't play that better. I gotta plug in my headset. All right, headset plugged in.
Well, that number is still in play because we said, okay, 20 or under gives them a chance to win. Right on pace for being in that range. And guess what?
Oh, it's Brian Hill, the running back. Okay, headset, can you stop? I literally can't charge it and play because it freezes my game every time it goes bleep.
I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line.
Great.
It's a first down on a gain of
10. Love when my players just die.
It's a simple tap pass, but it pays off in a big way.
And sometimes the simple stuff causes the most problems for a defense because there's a breakdown in communication there. When that receiver goes behind the line of scrimmage and it looks like he's going in motion, someone either has to go with him or he has to be passed off to another defender. Somehow, they didn't get that communicated well, and it turned into a nice play.
Off the play fake, here's Jackson. Open man, Taylor Gabriel.
Game. I'm glad it just... That was very clearly holding. Okay, let me just tell you what happened there. I had a corner there ready to tackle him, but your two guys were literally holding him by the arms. So he couldn't move. Oh, you gotta pick that.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Contain. I knew it. I knew exactly what was about to happen. I'm like, it's second down, it's Dippy, he has 85 speed. Death is about to happen.
Yeah, and then they go ahead and they double down with the whole thing because you think, okay, let's throw the ball. Oh, yeah, that's right, they defend the pass pretty well, too. Very difficult task right now.
That's incomplete.
Game in mid. There's nothing I can do.
It's a gain of 6 on play.
The game is just giving it to you now.
Now it's first and goal. Following the penalty, it's Hill. And he is met at the line of scrimmage.
Out of here with that shit.
No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's second and goal now. From the gun, Jackson. And with a flag down, he goes down. So they're able to sack him. Now the penalty looks like it could be holding. Let's find out.
Decline, because it gives you a third down.
And it takes another down off the series. But the biggest one of all, do you want to tell the guy who just got the sack that it no longer counts?
No.
No, not at all.
The holding penalty, that puts him in an unenviable spot here as they try again on third and goal. Back to throw. Gabriel. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Are you going for it or field goal? Okay, because it's like, it has no suggestions for me. I was like, what?
On now, Tucker McCain.
I was like,
from the
what?
Right hash, this from 33.
33 yard
attempt. McCain's kick.
Barely made it. onside, huh? Why would they run away?
They recovered it. They hang on now, though. There's a penalty flag down. So they touched it before it went 10, and that's obviously not going to help their comeback bid here in the fourth.
No, not at all. And they're trying to get something going, going after one there. But you've got to give yourself a chance. Let it go 10 before you touch it.
A first down throw for Bridgewater. Into the hands of his receiver, Anderson. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. 28 yards.
Hey man, at least Atlanta thought to actually touch the ball this time, unlike against the Cowboys.
What have you seen from him on film?
That was ridiculous.
I'll strip away everything else and get to what we call the moment of truth. When the ball's arriving, there's a defender there.
Couldn't trade him, huh? Vic Beasley, I saw him on the trade block.
Again, they run again. It's McCaffrey. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown.
Oh, but
Christian McCaffrey with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Panthers add on to their lead. And for them, this train, it just keeps rolling, doesn't it? Well on their way to yet another victory.
Yeah, it's almost a runaway, isn't it? And you just wonder how anyone could stop this. They got full momentum going, full confidence going.
I'm riding a serious wave of momentum.
Is leading them. It's the lack of confidence against their opponents now, because they see them coming and think, we've got no shot to beat this team.
Take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. Yeah, quick throw here, that's complete.
You have 2 wins. You won last week.
11 yards on that pickup. So from the
you're 2-2.
First and 10. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports.
Great question.
So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. He's going to take off with it. Man able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into his windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception. Really a bad throw, so maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
They go play action now. Jackson.
That camera angle made it look pretty bad. Did you fear for your life? Oh, what? He's holding his shoulder and his knee. What?
They go play action with Jackson.
Bet. Yeah, that was bound to happen. Yeah. He just kept running it, so I just had to keep running spies.
You can't afford to make any kind of mistakes.
I am.
But it's been pretty symptomatic what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. And he's going to bowl his
bruised shoulder. What about your knee?
Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and 5 at their 48-yard line.
Five and oh now.
The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here. 5 men in the secondary now for the Falcons on third down. So this one is over.
Who's that?
A victory for Carolina, and maybe more importantly, a victory in the division, which always helps.
And on the road. How about all of that rolled up into one? Because how often do you see division games get decided by this much of a margin?
Yeah, they thumped them.
Yeah, they jumped all over them. And a division game is usually a touchdown or less, because these two teams know each other better than most teams in the league. In this case, that didn't.